Spirit of God, fall fresh on.
Oh God, peel back the layers of my heart, and I want communion, I want fellowship, I want to be with you where you are. And oh God, the layers of my heart. I want communion. I want fellowship. I want to be with you where you are. 'Cause I want to be. Your heart is my refuge.
For me, oh,
To come, my cup. tasted the world, seen more than enough. Its promise is fleeting. Of water and wine, I emptied the cup and found myself wanting. But there is a well that never runs dry.
After my intercession. God, we thank you that you do not deal with us according to our sins or hold anything against us when we repent and fear your name. You are gracious, merciful, and slow to anger. We ask that this revelation would be over Israel, that when they come before you with different rituals, they would believe in your forgiveness to cover all sin, shame, and guilt. We also pray that any fear of sins not being forgiven or judgment would be broken in the name of Jesus. God, you promise that when we fear your name and love you with all our hearts, you will pour out your forgiveness and blessings upon your people. Would you strengthen us to love you, to fear you, and to rest assured of our acceptance? Let's pray.
Thank you.
Father, we declare that you delight over Israel. Over and over again, you have revealed your joy and delight over this nation, despite the number of times she has turned away from your ways. Today, we declare that you delight over each individual in Israel, and that they are the apple of your eye. We ask that this revelation sits in their hearts, and that their hearts are overwhelmed by your delight. We also pray that they understand that there is nothing the Jewish people can do or that they did to earn a greater amount of your affection for them. The truth is that they are worthy to be loved. They bring you joy, you burn for them, and you are well pleased with each person. Let's pray.
Thank you.
forefathers of Israel, the patriarchs of faith, your commitment to them because of your love for them. And this love has chased after Israel again and again. Nothing can stop you from having your people as your own. And we pray for a fresh revelation of this radical love over Israel. We ask that all the stories that they are familiar with become alive to them, and that it hits them in a new light like never before. God, there is nothing in this world that compares to the love you have for us. There is no one who can come close to what you have done for us. No other God is so great that eternity is not enough to know you fully. And so we pray for waves of revelation over Israel so that they grow in their knowledge and faith in your love. Let's pray. God, you have revealed to Israel your Son, Yeshua, to whom every part of Scripture points. He is the greatest manifestation of your forgiveness, your delight, and your love. But in your sovereign plan, you have placed a veil over the hearts of the Jews and ordained a hardening of their hearts and thus the inability for them to see the Messiahship of Jesus. But God, you have also commanded us to pray for Israel, and so we ask this morning that you would unveil and soften the hearts of the Jewish people, that they will see the one they have pierced. We pray for your grace and mercy to be poured out so that they're able to see that Jesus is the Son of the living God. And we pray that the wider body of Christ will sense the urgency to pray for Israel so that the day of the Lord's return will be hastened. Let's pray.
Thank you.
Father, we thank you for this new month and the privilege and the time and the opportunity we have to lift up the nation of Israel. Father, we pray that this month you renew our hearts for this nation, our hearts for interceding for this nation. God, that we'll take the commandment to pray for Israel seriously. And Father, we pray that the revelation of your forgiveness, of your radical love and your delight over Israel will lead your people to a revelation of Christ and what he has done for us. And Father, we pray that you would continue to soften the hearts of the Jewish people. And God, that we would press in with faith and hope and the faith to know that you will fulfill your promises. We thank you, Father. We lift all these things in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Thank you for joining us this morning. It is a new month, so we'll be meditating for this entire month. On Wednesday mornings, we'll be meditating through Psalm 23. Also praying for the nation of Israel. If you are somewhat relatively new in praying for Israel, it is something that God has commanded us to do, and something that the church has taken up as an assignment to pray on behalf of Israel. It is often very hard to get into it at the very beginning, but once God cultivates your heart for Israel in the place of prayer, there's really no way around it. You just have to pray, and that's how it happens. So we encourage you, if it is somewhat hard at first, we encourage you to keep pressing in, keep asking for more understanding, revelation, and God will be faithful in giving that heart to his church. So we're excited for this month. We hope that you are too. We'll see you once again next week. We also have a Thursday evening watch at 8 p.m. and we hope that you have a wonderful rest of the day. We'll see you once again.